After the strong storm we saw last night, there are usually storm chasers not far behind. In the next few weeks, if someone comes to your house and says you have roof damage, beware. New at 6 tonight, some tips from trusted professionals when it comes to dealing with roof damage. News 4's Angela Rodriguez shows us how to spot a scam.
The Five Forks area took a pounding like this, and while it may not look intimidating, even pea-sized hail can ruin a roof. Insurance adjusters and local roofers tell us over the past 18 months, the upstate's seen more hail than the past 8 years combined. Subdivisions in hard-hit areas can turn into prime targets for scammers.
The hail coming down, and not the size of golf balls, but the size of, goodness, like you'd make a snowball, and it just covered the entire lawn in white. And thankfully, no damage to the house.
Storm chasers hear this and look for ways to cash in. Insurance companies issue checks for materials and labors, but only once. If a homeowner gets scammed, then they're out of luck. So Premier Insurance offers this advice.
Smartest thing anybody could do is make sure they deal with a local reputable roofer, because that roof's going to be on there for the next 20 or 30 years, and they want to make sure whoever installs that roof is going to be there to service that roof for that next 20 or 30 years. So it's very important you have somebody who's not going to be here today and gone tomorrow.
Sim says never give anyone money up front. He says reputable roofers will gladly wait on insurance checks. And he says never sign any paperwork on the first day. He says the next few weeks are critical. Storm chasers will be casing neighborhoods.
I would warn anybody, be very careful about somebody coming to your front door knocking or walking around your yard or climbing up on your roof and saying, hey, you've got some kind of storm damage. Be very careful of that. A normal roofer, bona fide roofer in this area won't do that. Be careful.
It's also a good idea to check with the Better Business Bureau for complaints before you sign a roofing contract. Angela Rodriguez, WYFF News 4.